10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Ignition and liftoff. In Boca Aruco, go Falcon, go Cosmo.
Vehicle is pitching downrange. M1D chamber pressures are nominal.
Falcon 9 has successfully lifted off from Pad 40 at Cape Canaveral Space Force Station, carrying the COSMO-SkyMed satellite to a polar sun synchronous orbit. Now, during ascent, we tilt the engines, and that's what we call gimballing, and that turns the rocket horizontally. That's what we call a gravity turn. We're still going up, but we're now also heading horizontally away from the launch pad. The rocket typically needs to go about...
9 is supersonic.
We need to go about 17,500 miles per hour horizontally in order to avoid being pulled back down to Earth.
Max Q.
And there we heard the call out for Max Q. We have now passed through the maximum aerodynamic pressure. This is the largest structural load on the vehicle. And with that, we do have 5 events coming up back to back. They'll happen within seconds of each other. And these events include the first stage making its way back to landing zone 1 today. So we'll have MECO, main engine cutoff, stage separation, a flip of the first stage, SES-1, or second stage engine start 1, and then followed immediately by a boostback run on the first stage. Again, that's 5 events happening within seconds of each other. We should get some good views of these happening. Again, that is MECO, stage separation, S-1 flip. Good call-outs there. So stage 1 flip, SES-1, and the boostback run coming up here in a few seconds.
Steve. See that dot? That's it coming back, and it's going to relight.
Oh, with the pulses.
Yeah. It's going back to Kennedy Space Center, so we're going to get the sonic boom.
Yeah.
look at it. Look how fast it's going now. Where are you going? See it? You see it? It's, I'll tell you when it's about to hit the first wire. It still has another one to do, but I don't think we'll see it.